A program crashes and I can't uninstall it. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right into the question. For some reason now, I have Mozilla Firefox and it continues to crash, so I'd like to uninstall it. When I go to try uninstall, I get a message that reads the program running has to finish first. I don't know what this is. I also downloaded an uninstaller. When I run it, it seems to hang up on deleting the files. I did get it to a finished place and it told me I should buy the full version. I even did it as Mozilla advised and downloaded a newer version, except that it doesn't seem to have downloaded as I can't finish anything. I am majorly confused. Yes, there are definitely some confusing aspects of your scenario and I want to walk through some of them. But there are interesting situations where we can all end up here having a program that isn't working properly and for whatever reason fails to install. Here are the steps that I'd take. First, I have to point out that the error messages you see are critical. And I don't mean just noting that they exist. I mean noting exactly what they say. For example, I'm pretty sure that there was no message that says the program running has to finish first. There was probably more specific wording involved in that message. And even if not, there was more specific information available, like at exactly when this happened, what other characteristics of the message box had, and so forth. It seems pedantic on my part, and I apologize for that, but this is one of those things that can really make or break someone's ability to help you resolve a problem. And that is, be as complete and clear and specific about steps and error messages as you possibly can be. It really does make a difference. It seems like a lot of work up front, I get that, but it really does make a difference. And honestly, if you're not willing to put the work up in front to write down the error messages or capture them, you're not really saying that much for those of us who then have to put in the work to try and figure out what you really meant. So pay attention to the error messages, please. So step one, I didn't see this in your description, so I'm going to suggest you do this right away. Reboot. Seriously, rebooting your machine makes so many problems go away. It is one of those things that just as a knee-jerk reaction for things that it wouldn't even seem to apply to, we often say, have you rebooted yet, right? It's a meme. Have you rebooted your machine? Have you turned it off and back on again? There are a lot of things that that resolves. And at least a couple of the scenarios that you described, a couple of the symptoms that you described, feel like the kind of symptoms that would go away if you rebooted. So I hope you did, but if you didn't, reboot. Number two, try an uninstallation program. I know you've tried one, you didn't tell me which one. I'm going to suggest you try something called Revo Uninstaller. These programs typically have several levels of what I'll call aggressiveness. And depending on how well they work at the less aggressive settings, you may need to turn it up. Definitely back up your machine before you run an uninstaller. But once you've done so, you can run them safely knowing that you can't break it any worse than it was when you started, because you could always restore to that backup. But running a tool like Revo Uninstaller may actually go in and find some of the things that were left over by a previous uninstall, or better yet, a previous uninstall that never finished. Number three. I would download and run Process Explorer. Process Explorer is like Task Manager on steroids. Task Manager in Windows 10 has gotten better, don't get me wrong, but Process Explorer remains better yet. It has more detailed information and it's a little bit easier to navigate, at least in my opinion. The important thing about Process Explorer is you can then see if there are processes that appear to be related to whatever it is you're trying to run or uninstall. In your case, it was Mozilla Firefox. So you might just see if there are other processes running that appear to be related to Firefox. Firefox.exe, the Mozilla Updater, I mean, any number of things by name. And you can then use Process Explorer to kill them, to make them go away. At that point, you may then be able to either uninstall or reinstall or do something. You may be able to get further. But that, again, if this were my situation, if I were facing this myself, That's what I would do next. Step four, I would actually download the program from scratch. In other words, in case of Mozilla Firefox, I would download the latest copy of Firefox and just try to install it. Sometimes the installation of software can fix things that were broken by its previous uninstallation. If that's the case, by the way, if the install looks to work, I would then immediately uninstall it. Not because I don't want to use the program anymore, but I want that uninstall to be successful. I want it to go through and clean up whatever it made sense to clean up on the way out. Then I would reinstall Firefox or whatever app you're having problems with again from scratch. And step six, well, you know, it's like I kind of ranted about at the beginning. Pay careful attention to the error messages. Write them down carefully or take screenshots if you have that ability. It's a great way to actually provide more information than you realize, because there's usually a lot of context beyond just the message. There's the window it appears in, the windows that are around, the state of the system, and so forth. These are all things that sometimes become apparent, even accidentally, in a screenshot. So save those, prepare those, and use those then when you come to folks like me or to the Mozilla support forums or to wherever you go looking for help. Hope that gives you some things to try, some things to think about. For links related to this video, for updates, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/6400. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.